The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Are you familiar with the old expression... When they made you, they threw away the mold? Or, there's nobody else like you in the whole world. What is it inside every human being that makes him or her unique? One of a kind.
What kind of a doctor are you? What kind of a place is this? Why won't anyone believe me?
Now, Susan, this is the last time I'm going to ask you. Calm yourself.
Calm myself? How many times do I have to tell you I'm not Susan?
That's enough. Take her back to her
room. I'm not Susan. It's all a mistake.
Susan, stop
it. I'm telling you the truth. I'm Anita. I'm Anita.
You'll feel better tomorrow.
Leave me, please. I'm not Susan. I'm not Susan.
Our mystery drama, The Deadly Double, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Vicki Dan and stars Marian Seldes. It is sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, Brewers of Budweiser, and Buick Motor Division. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Her name is Anita Gregory, and she leads a quiet life, an almost solitary life, except for a single casual friendship. It isn't that she likes being alone. She has her painting to keep her occupied and a considerable sum of money in the bank to ensure her independence. It's just that she prefers a peaceful existence. For there are certain things that happened long ago that she would prefer to forget. She has no way of knowing, however, that tonight those certain things are about to intrude unexpectedly from the past and totally disrupt the serenity of the present.
Look, Anita, there's this great old flick on Channel 9.
I don't care, Max. Now, why don't you go home?
Well, it's not even 1 o'clock.
Not even 1 o'clock. Max, I want to go to sleep.
Why are you mad at me?
I'm not mad at you. You're using me as an excuse.
What are you talking about?
You haven't written so much as a sentence in the past month.
Anita, I've explained that to you. There comes a time in every writer's creative life when he reaches an impasse, what you might call a writer's block.
Get off it, Max. You like the idea of being a writer, but deep inside, you are basically a bum.
Huh?
I'm your friend, so I can tell you. Why do you delude yourself?
Well, I need fresh ideas. I need fresh ideas to rejuvenate me.
Good night, Max.
Well, it's not like you and your painting. All you have to do is look out the window at some tree... And you're inspired.
My pictures are good, Max, because I don't sit around waiting to be inspired. I paint what I see, a face, a tree in the wind, a leaf.
Anita, you don't understand. You...
Who would call this late? Hello? What? But how... Now? Well, I... Yes, where? Yes. All right. Yes, I promise, I promise.
Alida, you okay? Who was that?
I can't believe it.
Who was that on the phone?
My sister.
Your sister?
Susan.
Susan the nut?
Oh, don't call her that. She's just disturbed.
Well, she's in an institution, isn't she?
It's a rest home, Max. How many times do I have to tell you? It's a rest home.
Well, call it what you want. You're the one who pays the bill. Hey, you really look shook up. What's the matter?
I haven't seen Susan. It's been 5 years. And now she, what? She's out.
She's out? When'd they release her?
They didn't.
They didn't? Wait a minute. You mean she escaped?
She left.
I'll call the police.
No, don't do that.
What?
No police. No, there can't be anybody else. I know where she is, and I'll take care of this in my own way.
Anita, I don't want to be difficult, but you're the one who signed the commitment papers. You're the one who had her declared insane.
I never even went up there to Westbrook. I couldn't. But 5 years is a long time. People change.
Anita...
A lot of things can happen in 5 years. She said she was trying to get in touch with me for a long time. They wouldn't let her write or phone or anything.
Anita, where are you going?
Lock the door when you leave, Max.
Let me come with you.
No, I have to go alone. It'll be all right. I know what I'm doing.
Call me when you get back?
Sure.
I'll be waiting up for you. Remember, I'm just down the hall.
I've got to go.
Anita.
What?
I hope you know what you're doing.
So do I. Said there'd be a phone booth. God, where is she? Susan? Susan? It's me, Anita. Where are you? Susan? Is that you? Who's there? Susan, it's you. Oh. Yes, Anita, it's me. Susan, thanks for being stupid enough to come.
Miss, taking a nap, miss?
Mm-hmm. What? Where am I?
Well, you're a mile off Highway 25 at 2 o'clock in the morning.
Oh. Oh, she must have knocked me off. Oh, where's my car?
Huh? What car? Say, you better get into my car. You must be freezing in that thin dress.
Dress? Could have sworn I was wearing... Well, she did it. She changed clothes with me on top of everything.
What are you talking about, miss?
My sister, she took my car. My wallet, she even changed into... Wait, are you a policeman?
No, we don't have policemen here, miss. I'm the sheriff. My name's Tom Wiley.
Oh, I'm Anita Gregory.
Well, pleased to meet you, Miss Gregory. Well, now, why don't you get in my car before you get pneumonia?
Are you taking me down to the station or whatever it is that you call it around here?
Well, actually, we call it the sheriff's office.
Well, I don't mean to inconvenience you or anything.
Oh, no, it's my job. Now, suppose you start all over again and tell me exactly what happened. Now, you say Susan is your sister?
Twin sister.
Oh, twin sister. Miss Gregory, I still don't understand how you could agree to meet her on a deserted highway. Didn't you know she was dangerous?
No. Well, I wasn't sure.
You weren't sure?
Well, you see, she sounded so upset. And I was so surprised to hear from her in the first place. It's been 5 years. Well, how did I know if she'd gotten better or not?
Now, Miss Gregory, don't
call
you think
me an Anita. I hate Miss Gregory. That sounds so hard.
I never liked formality myself.
Wait a minute. This doesn't look like a sheriff's office. That sign says Westbrook. Why are we stopping here?
Hey, Doc.
Sheriff, where'd you find her?
Well, you know where that phone booth is off of X 11? Well, she was frankly lying in the road. Lucky I came by when I did.
Susan, you might have gotten killed.
My name is Anita Gregory. I don't think we've met. And I don't see why it's any of your business.
Susan, do you realize that because of your little escapade, everybody's been up half the night trying to find you?
Wait a minute. I don't think you heard me. I'm not...
I heard what you said. Eric, take Susan Gregory back to her room.
Sheriff!
I'm sorry, but I had to bring you back.
Bring me back?
We really appreciate it, Sheriff. Thank you.
Back? This is all a mistake.
I think you need a sedative.
Need a what? Who do you think you are?
That's not our problem. The problem is, who do you think you are, Susan?
You think that I'm Susan?
Eric?
And you, Sheriff? You brought me here deliberately. You don't believe me either. That whole time in the car, you were playing along with me. All the time thinking I'm somebody else.
Well, I'm sorry, but you might have gotten hurt.
This is insane. It isn't really happening. Tomorrow I'll wake up and... Let go of me.
Take her to her room, Eric. Restrain her if necessary.
Doctor, please, this is all a mistake. It's a horrible mistake. If I'm here, then Susan is out there somewhere. Miles away now in my car.
Susan, you must
stop. Wait a minute. No, now look. Find her before she hurts somebody, please. Sheriff, listen to me. My name is Anita Gregory. I live at 420 Oakleaf Terrace. Look, if you don't believe me, ask Max. That's right, Max knows. He was there when Susan called. Max will tell you. Please believe me. Please, please.
Yeah, that poor girl. It's really a shame about people like her. In the car, she seemed so normal.
She's schizoid. Thinks she's two people.
You mean this Anita character?
That's the sad part. She does have a sister, Anita, who put her here.
There is a sister?
That's right. Twin sister. As a matter of fact, I think that's part of the reason she has such a serious identity problem.
Twin? Is it remotely possible that the girl I brought back is the other sister?
Sheriff, you're not serious.
Well, I know I'm no psychiatrist, but looking back on it, she didn't seem that crazy to me.
That girl was Susan. She couldn't fool me for a minute.
A perfect example of being in the wrong place at the right time. As far as Dr. Cooper is concerned, Susan is back where she can't harm anybody. As far as Sheriff Wiley is concerned, he has just apprehended a dangerous lunatic. But what about Anita? She is about to discover that while it is relatively easy to prove a person is insane, it is quite a different matter to prove that a person is sane. I'll be back in a moment with Act Two. By all physical appearances, Anita Gregory is identical to her sister Susan. Same eyes, same hair, same voice, but the similarity ends there because no two minds can ever be the same. It is merely logical that Dr. Cooper will presently recognize her for what she really is. Or is it?
Good morning, Susan. Well, how do you feel?
What? Oh, was it morning?
Yes, morning, more or less. It's 11:30, but you had a rather late night.
Oh, no. Oh, I thought I'd dreamt all this.
Oh. No, Susan. And that's why after last night, we must make an even more determined effort to face reality.
Call me Susan once more and I'm going to scream.
Good, go right ahead. It's good therapy. Let out all your hostility.
Isn't it at all conceivable to you that being identical twins, Susan and I might have changed places?
Well, yes, there is that possibility.
Good. We're getting somewhere. Now, what about a phone call?
I'm afraid that's out of the question.
We could clear this matter up entirely with a single phone call.
Oh, you know the rules about phone calls. Besides, after last night's escapade, you've had all privileges suspended.
Doctor, when I get out of here, I'll make sure you never practice again.
Oh, that's excellent. Redirected hostility.
I must be calm. I must maintain my cool. Doctor, explain to me about my case.
You know all about your case.
Please, humor me.
Yeah, very well. Your name is Susan Gregory. 5 years ago, following a series of incidents where you repeatedly attempted to kill your sister, Anita, you were declared legally insane.
Now, those incidents, couldn't they have been merely frustration or anger of the moment?
Unfortunately, no. You see, it's been inside you since you were a child. No matter what you did, your sister did it better. The years went on, and you watched as Anita became a successful artist. You grew more and more resentful. Your jealousy became an obsession. Even now, you're often jealous enough to try to be her. In this way, you can have what she's always had.
All right. Now, taking this a step further, just pretend now, that the real Susan Gregory is out there, living in Anita's apartment and driving her car, pretending to be her. How long do you suppose she'll be able to carry it off before she gets caught?
Not very long, of course. Little things, traits unique to Anita would be missing. Close friends notice these things. That is, if Anita has any close friends.
Oh, she has.
We'll discuss it all later. It's time for your treatment.
Kind of treatment?
Eric is waiting outside to take you to therapy 3.
I asked you, what kind of treatment?
Eric, would you take her, please? I'll be down in a few minutes.
Look, I'm not stupid. I took psychology in college. I know a little bit about behavior modification and the things they do in places like this. Now, what is it? Is it electric shock therapy?
No, I don't know why you're so upset. You'll feel much better. You always do afterwards.
It is. Now, listen. Staying here for a few days is one thing. Now, I've tried discussing the whole thing rationally with you, and what happens? You aren't going to give me any shock treatment.
Eric?
You call yourself a doctor, you're a charlatan, you're a quack.
Now, you see, Susan, it's just a matter of time before your true nature comes through. You're hysterical.
Just wait till I get out of here. I'm going to sue you. I'll sue this hospital. I'll sue everybody.
Well, Sister Anita, you've done all right for yourself. This is a nice little apartment. I think I'm going to like it here. Mustn't get excited. I can pull this off, just remember. I'm Anita now. Yes?
Well, aren't you going to let me in? Look, don't be mad. I can explain why I didn't wait up for you. I fell asleep. I just went out like a light the minute I hit the couch. Anyhow, tell me what happened.
With what?
Well, Anita, don't keep me in suspense like this. What happened with your crazy sister?
I sent her back to Westbrook. We had a long chat, and then I drove her back.
And that was it?
Yeah, she just wanted to talk.
So, everything's all right now?
Everything's fine.
Hey, this is your old friend Max. If something's bothering you, you can tell me.
Max, of course not. I'm just tired.
You sure nothing's bothering you? You're not mad at me?
Oh, of course not. Come here.
Here?
Closer.
Oh, Anita.
See? I'm not mad at you.
Why? Why did you kiss me?
Why?
You never kissed me before. You said I wasn't ready for a serious relationship. You wanted to keep it platonic.
I did. Oh. Well, sorry, Max. If you don't like it, I won't do it again.
Oh, well, no, I'm not sorry. Oh,
yeah, Max, I have a headache.
You asking me to leave, Anita?
Yes, do you mind?
No. No, sure, I understand.
Maybe some other time, okay?
Sure.
Bye now.
Bye.
Oh, that was close. I hope that dummy swallowed it.
Susan, how do we feel today?
We? How do we feel? I only wish you could feel like I feel right now.
I have a surprise for you. You have a visitor.
What did you say?
Someone's here to see you. He says he's an old friend. Max Hogan.
Max? Max is here?
Do you want to see him?
Max! Oh, wonderful, beautiful Max!
I'll send him in. You can come in, Mr. Hogan. I'll be right outside.
Max!
Anita.
Oh, I'm so glad you came. I thought I was going crazy.
Anita, it is you.
Well, of course it's me.
Well, I wasn't sure.
Max, I've got to get out of this place.
Don't worry. Never fear, Max is here. Wow, this is wild.
But it isn't funny. Now, how did you figure I was here?
Give me credit, honey. I had her pegged for Susan the minute she opened the door.
She's in my apartment?
Sure. Making like she's you. But she didn't fool me for a minute.
No.
What really did it was when she kissed me.
She what?
Now, you see, you'd never do that. I mean, she assumed I was your boyfriend.
Oh, I can't wait to see the look on that doctor's face when you tell him. Max, would you get Dr. Cooper and tell him who I really am?
Hey, what an idea for a story. Two sisters, twin sisters, who changed places.
Yes, you have my permission to write the story. Now get Dr. Cooper and we can discuss it on the way home.
Sure, of course. I have to go into greater depth, take more time to evolve my characters.
You aren't thinking what I think you're thinking.
I could come up a couple of times a week with a tape recorder.
Oh, no, you can't be thinking that.
Anita, please, just give me a few weeks. That's all I need.
No!
But can't you see? It's perfect. I haven't been inspired for months. You said so yourself.
Absolutely not.
And the story would practically write itself. It's a bestseller. We rip the facade off mental institutions. What an expose.
I said no.
Oh, how can you be so selfish?
Selfish? I'm being selfish?
Can't you see? I'm 36 years old and I've never been published.
You don't seem to understand that every day I'm in this place, I lose a little bit more of my grip. There's drugs, there's shock therapy. Do you know what that can do to a person?
Oh, come on. Now, it can't be that bad.
I'm through to you. This place can drive anybody crazy. I thought that I could live through anything. Nothing ever really moved me or excited me.
Well, that's just why you could pull it off.
Yeah, but even if my mind was made of concrete, this place would erode it.
We'd be rich, both of us. Hey, well, I'll tell you what. I'll give you 50%.
And you're forgetting something else. Susan.
All right. She'll get a percentage, too.
Now, listen, Max. Forget about me for a minute. You can't let an insane person loose in the normal world.
Why not? It's all relative, isn't it? Isn't the whole world going crazy? Who are we to say what is and what isn't normal? What a thief!
Listen! Hey! You don't know Susan. She's dangerous.
She seemed all right. Besides, weren't you the one who said that maybe the doctors were wrong?
Well, I made a mistake. She hasn't changed at all. She's vicious. She could even kill.
Don't try to talk me out of it.
Listen, take me seriously for once. When we were little, even then, she did vicious things. She broke the heads off all my dolls. She took the goldfish out of the bowl and she watched them die.
Typical healthy tomboy.
I don't want to discuss it anymore.
Now get me out of here, please.
All right, Anita. Sure. That's how you want it. Doctor, I'm ready to go now.
All right, now tell him, Max. Tell the doctor.
Tell him what?
Who I am. Doctor, Max knows.
I think this has been too much of a strain for her. You'd better go immediately.
Of course.
Max!
Goodbye,
Max.
Doctor. Goodbye,
no,
Susan.
Oh, no, Max, she'll kill you. When she finds out that you know, she'll kill you.
We live in a world ravaged with fear. A world where the voices of logic and common sense seldom find a sympathetic listener. It is not so very unlike the purgatory in which Anita Gregory is now imprisoned. Today, into that dim world, a candle of hope has briefly flickered and finally been extinguished. I'll be back shortly with Act 3. Je pense, donc je suis. I think, therefore I am. So said the great philosopher René Descartes. It was this brilliant Frenchman who logically demonstrated that there is only one thing of which a man can be sure of, and that is his own existence. After all, most people accept what they see as truth. They do not question the obvious. They leave that for the philosophers.
Hello, Doctor.
Sheriff, what brings you here?
Well, you know what happened was I was typing up the week's report, and I suddenly realized that I never got you to sign this release for that Gregory girl. It was such a hectic night, it totally slipped my mind.
Of course.
Also, could you fill in her sister's full name and address? I need it for the records.
I'm glad you stopped by. She was asking for you.
For me?
Yes, she says there's something she'd like to tell you. Now, you don't have to see her if you don't want to.
Hmm?
I'm sure it isn't anything important.
Oh, well, as long as I'm here, I'd like to see how she's doing. Hello, Susan.
Sheriff?
Oh, how you been?
Just wonderful, can't you tell?
Doc Cooper said you wanted to see me.
I did?
What was it you wanted to tell me?
I forget. I think there was something. Why can't I remember?
Oh, now, take your time.
I want to tell you.
Nice paintings on the wall.
Oh, that's the doctor's idea. He feels by giving us a creative outlet, it's releasing hostility.
Very good.
Well, I'm a professional artist. I mean, Anita's a professional artist. I'm supposed to be Susan. Susan can't paint. Susan cooks. Anita paints. It's always been that way.
Well, I'm sure no art critic, but I think you're very good.
Yes, you know I am. Look at that wall. Look at the girl in the picture there. Her hands, her arms, there, by her neck. Do you know how many years of training it takes? The discipline, anatomy classes, live models to get the bones, the muscles, the skin tones just right to understand the shading.
Well, like I said, it's very good.
Would you say I have a style?
Style? Yeah. Yeah, I'd say so.
See, it takes years to develop a style. I spent 2 years in Paris. That's heaven for an artist. And that's what influenced me, those early impressionists. But Max says I still have a distinctive style. Oh, Max, that's what I wanted to tell you.
What about Max?
She's going to kill Max.
Who's going to kill Max?
That's right. Now, Max is writing a book about us, how we changed places. And I warned him. I said, Max, Susan hates to be tricked, and she hates people fooling her, and when she finds out that you know who she is, she's going to get really mad, and she'll kill you.
That's very interesting.
You think I'm crazy, don't you?
Oh, no, I didn't say that.
That's all right. It's quite all right. I tried. I did my best. I warned him. And he didn't believe me either. When Max is found dead, maybe then you'll believe me. That's all I wanted to tell you. Thanks for coming.
Oh, there's no trouble. I wanted to see how you were doing.
Now, if you'll excuse me. I'm very tired.
Sure. I was just leaving. Well, bye, Susan.
Sheriff, wait a minute. You want this back?
Huh? Oh, the release form. Oh. Thanks, Doc. I don't know what's with me these days. Look, I want to ask you about Susan's sister, Nita Gregory.
What about her?
I was wondering when you saw her last.
Last?
Hmm.
Oh, well, I really don't think that's very important.
Well, what is your impression of the sister, Nita?
I hear she's an excellent artist.
You hear?
Yeah, well, naturally, I've never met her.
You what?
There really wasn't any need to. I mean, she pays the bills on time, and she never comes to visit.
When did Susan start painting?
Just recently.
How recently?
Well, I don't see why. Well, about a week ago. She isn't bad for a beginner. Matter of fact, she's pretty good.
Did it occur to you that maybe she was too good?
Chapter 2, the second week. Oh, that's good. Let's see what we've got so far. Meanwhile, Susan Gregory, in the guise of Anita, continued more and more to assume the identity of her sister.
The door wasn't locked, so I just thought I'd come in.
Ah, I never lock my door.
What are you writing?
Nothing, just the usual junk.
Can I see?
No. I never show an unfinished work to anybody. It just isn't done.
Why not?
Well, it's bad luck. Hey, give me that back.
I just want to see. Come on, don't be such
a... Give it back.
Come on, Max. Just let me see a
give
little.
Give it to me. Now look what you've done.
Oh. I'm sorry, Max. I'm really sorry.
Sure.
I mean, you're so funny. You get so excited about a silly piece of paper.
No, I wouldn't expect you to understand.
Why not?
Well, it's very personal. When a writer writes, what you did just now was almost like tearing me in half physically. I don't see what's so funny.
You don't? It's very funny. It's a scream. It's a scream. You know, it's a scream.
No, I...
You're a scream. You know that? As a matter of fact, you're plain crazy.
Me? Crazy?
Don't look so shocked. Don't fight it. It's no crime to be crazy. It happens to the best of us.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, you're not taking me seriously, are you, Max? I'm only kidding. Can't you take a joke?
No, sure.
I tell you what. You come over about 6, and I'll make you some chili. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Yes, I would.
Okay. 6, then. Max? Just a minute. Max, I told you Oh.
Miss, Anita Gregory?
Yes.
It's amazing.
I beg your pardon?
Oh, the resemblance. It's fantastic. Oh, between you and your sister, I mean.
My sister?
Susan Gregory. I'm an acquaintance of hers. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me introduce myself.
I wish you would.
The name's Wiley. Tom Wiley. I'm sheriff up in Clay County. Near Westbrook, where your sister is staying.
Sheriff?
Could I come in for a minute?
Oh, well, of course. Please.
Thank you. Well, you have a very nice apartment, Miss Gregory.
Well, thank you. Well, what can I do for you, Sheriff?
You see, I'm the officer who apprehended your sister after she escaped from Westbrook, and Well, she was really nice and likable, and to be perfectly honest,
Yes, be perfectly honest.
Well, I have to admit there was a remote possibility that, well, she might have been a victim of mistaken identity.
Oh.
You know, you're not at all what I expected you to be.
Oh, what were you expecting, an ogre?
Oh, I don't know, really.
Are you disappointed?
Well, kind of.
Something wrong?
Well, these paintings.
Yes?
You painted them?
Oh, well, I almost hate to admit it, but look, I can't expect everyone to love my work.
Oh, I didn't say that I didn't like them. It's just the... Well, have a style. It's very distinctive.
Oh, here it comes. Everyone's a critic.
I honestly like your work, Anita. Well, I really better get back. Thanks. Thanks for everything.
Yes, sure.
Oh, by the way, you wouldn't happen to know a guy named Max?
Max?
Hmm.
Oh, sure. He lives down the hall. I thought it was him at the door before. Why?
Well, I'm wondering if it's the same Max.
The same Max?
Hmm. Your sister had a visitor the other day, a guy named Max, and I was just wondering if it could be this...
No, no. The Max that I know never met Susan. You see, I don't like to let new friends know that my sister... You understand. I mean...
Oh, sure. I understand, sure. Well, it was just a thought. Thanks anyway. Bye.
Goodbye. So, Max does know. All this time I trusted that idiot. And he knew all along... That must have been what he was writing about, wanted to hide from me. It all fits. All this time he made a fool of me. He tricked me.
Hey, Anita. Why'd you lock your door? It's only old Max.
No, Max, just a minute. Hello, Max.
Why'd you lock me out? Here, I brought some wine. I thought we'd have a nice evening.
Thank you, Max. I guarantee you this is going to be an evening you'll never forget.
Oh, I must say, Anita, you really outdid yourself. That chili was fantastic.
Well, you certainly ate enough.
Yeah, well, I'm positively stuffed. Let's have some more wine.
But you finished it all.
Oh.
By the way, Max, how's your book coming?
My book?
Yeah, your book. You never did tell me what it was about.
Well, it's just
about... Tell me something, Max. Did you put me in it?
You?
Yeah, me. I'm your inspiration, aren't I?
What's gotten into you, Anita?
Don't call me Anita. I hate that name. You know very well I'm Susan.
What?
Oh, don't play dumb, Max. You knew all the time, didn't you?
didn't you?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm Susan, and you knew all about it. Oh, quit playing dumb. I happen to know all about your little visit to Westbrook.
Oh, look, I can explain.
I don't want to hear it. I'm not interested. I'm more interested in this bookend. Did you know, Max, that there are only two like it in the whole world, that they belong to my grandfather, that they came all the way from Spain? They're made of mahogany. They're hand-carved. But look, notice the base. That's solid bronze.
Hey, what are you doing?
I thought you liked me, but you were just using me, making a fool of me. You tricked me.
Susan.
No,
wait a second. Let me explain.
I get mad when people fool me. I get really mad.
Susan, no. Put that down. You could kill somebody with that.
I intend to kill you.
Oh, no. Look.
Max, you're such an easy target.
Hey, you're crazy.
I'll kill you.
Please.
Kill
Susan.
You. Please. You liar. I'll kill you.
Susan, stand still. Don't move.
You're too late. Sheriff, he's dead. I killed him.
No, he's not dead. He just fainted.
No, he's dead.
He's alive, Susan. Not that I really care after what he did to your sister.
I wanted to kill him. I'm not sorry. He tricked me, you know.
I know. Now, are you ready to go back now, Susan?
Susan. But you know? How?
You told me with your paintings. You see, your sister has a distinctive style. She tried to tell me that in Westbrook. She duplicated from memory those three paintings on that wall. Exactly.
Anita's the artist, but I don't care. Max, I didn't really mean to hurt him.
I understand.
But I'm still not sorry. I'm not sorry about anything. You can take me back now.
All right, Susan.
Susan. Susan. That's a nice name.
The sheriff took Susan home to Westbrook. And Anita, after many embarrassed apologies, is back at work. I understand she's been commissioned to do a mural inside the sheriff's office. For those of you wondering about the unfortunate Max, it seems Dr. Cooper was very interested to learn of his book. So interested, in fact, that he's made Max a permanent fixture up at Westbrook. You could call him the resident author. I'll be right back. To any of you who are asking if there is a moral, a lesson to be learned from our little story, let me assure you, we do not attempt to moralize. We do not presume to teach. However, if you happen to be close friends with a writer who is hard up for a story, I would just say, be prepared for anything. Our cast included Marian Seldes, Robert Dryden, and Leon Janney. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
I'm sorry, son, I didn't understand. Those were the six words.
Sorry for what?
For remembering me. I wouldn't expect you to forget immediately, of course. That would be unreasonable. But as soon as possible, put me out of her mind. My life on Earth was over.
I'm sure she meant well, your mother.
After you're here a while, you'll realize that everybody doesn't mean well, and quite often does a lot of harm.
But your mother loved you.
Then why not leave me alone to enjoy myself? Why wake up in the middle of the night to remember how handsome I looked the day I graduated from dental college? So inconsiderate.
Why was it inconsiderate?
Because, my dear fellow, if she kept it up long enough, I'd have to stop whatever I was doing and go visit her.
How could you do that?
Well, the way it's always done. As a ghost, of course.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Uncle Ben's Long Grain and Wild Rice. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.